Sandy West, born as Sandra Sue Pesavento, was born on July 10, 1959. She's probably most notably known for having been the drummer in the all-girls 70s rock band The Runaways. In interviews, Sandy stated that initially she was interested in following the footsteps of her older sister, who played violin. At the age of 9, her grandfather bought her a drum set, and she started practicing the instrument. She had a natural talent that shone when she was in school and in her early teen years when she'd be the only female drummer that would play at teen parties. At the age of 15, she met Kim Fowley, who recruited her and the other eventual members of the Runaways. In 1975, at the age of 16, Sandy and the other Runaways formed the popular female band that was rife with drama. In the documentary Edge Play, the teen girls would go between waves of caring about each other and then fighting each other. Though it seemed that Sandy wasn't much to get into the incidents. Sandy played on all the albums with the Runaways. In 1979, the band broke up and everyone went their separate ways. Even though Lita Ford and Sandy West had similar musical interests and playing styles, the two didn't end up creating music together. After the Runaways, Sandy continued to play live venues and formed her own band called Sandy West Band. They released one album called The Beat Goes On. I cannot find any physical copies of it other than on the Discogs website, which states that it was released in 2000. When not playing venues, Sandy had to work in other areas to earn money. Unfortunately, she had turned to some dark areas that were lightly touched upon in the movie Edge Play. Sandy stated that she had broken someone's arm, shoved a gun down another person's throat in order to get money that was owed to others. She alluded to having been to jail potentially multiple times. Beyond that, Sandy worked in construction for 20 years, having also worked as a veterinary assistant and bartender at different points. Sandy always felt like the band shouldn't have broken up, and that there should have been at least a reunion between the women. She looked upon the time they shared fondly, feeling that their talent would have gotten them farther than they did. Unfortunately, Sandy was diagnosed with lung cancer after years of heavy smoking in 2005. The cancer spread to her brain, and October 21st, 2006, Sandy passed away. In her obituary, Sandy had memoirs that she had completed, of which her manager at the time, Mara Fox, hoped to have published. As of 2020, there do not seem to be any plans for the potential book. Her former bandmate stated, "We shared the dreams of girls playing rock and roll. Sandy was an exuberant and powerful drummer. I'm overcome from the loss of my friend. I always told her we changed the world," said Joan Jett. Sandy is buried in the Forest Lawn Memorial Park Cemetery in Cypress, California. She was 47.